Hey guys, New Street Gaming here today, and today I've got an experiment for FIFA 16. Sadly, it will not be EA Access or the actual game, it's on the demo. So this is the closest I'm going to get until the game actually comes out, because I do not have an Xbox One, I'm on PS4. So I will not get the EA Access, and I wanted to make this video sooner rather than later. I will be testing this when the game comes out too, just to make sure not too much has changed. It doesn't seem like much will change though, because there will only be a few tiny little tweaks from now on out, of course. So I've gone and built the slowest team on FootDraft I could possibly make. The fastest player I think is my centre back Albiol, with 61 and Albiol 61 pace. So I've gone with the slowest goalkeeper for speed and the slowest for pace, of course. I did a foot draft because other teams are going to have faster players, and they'll end up, if I go for slower players, they'll probably end up being bronze and silver. So I've gone for foot draft. I've gone for a very central formation because I feel like the wingers tend to be quite fast. Like, you have the likes of Blaszczykowski, 83 pace, and all those sort of guys who are quite quick out wide. So I just wanted to go with some players that didn't have over 70 pace, of course, so I run up a very central formation. So I'm just going to hop into a game against Chelsea on World Class, and I'll bring you guys the highlights to see if it does matter, and I'll tell you my final feeling about it. I'll see you guys in a second. Alright, so we're trying to beat Eden Hazard, we've beaten him, which is quite surprising. Left as the equator.
Hazard's catching up though. Such a feature of this game.
Like, even with the strength, I couldn't hold him off there. The pace was a little bit too much.
Once he's got
although
the ball,
I did beat
down,
a couple of plays
he lifts his
just
chin
a second
and
ago,
he picks
saw
the best option.
But I guess it's not too bad. Oh my days, we are not catching him. We are not catching him.
Well done, the goalkeeper.
Yeah.
And he's hung on to brilliant team play
oh,
this.
No, he's
with
gone.
The passing,
he is
the
gone.
Movement off
There's
the
no
ball
chance.
To make the passing possible.
Challenge. It's moving a little
really
gingerly on it, but at the moment doesn't want to come off.
Thanks, Jeff. Spot on.
That was a perfect.
Trying to keep the ball.
Way
not anymore.
To show that pace does matter on the wings. Yeah, we couldn't run through there. Oscar's too quick for dust.
Chelsea on the
All right, so we'll see if we can run to the box with Totti.
That's good support play from his teammates.
Oh.
Francesco Totti!
Oh my days.
And he's put it away beautifully.
He's got such good dribbling. I feel like the dribbling is more of a bigger factor in the game. Because you can be slow and have good dribbling, you can just weave in and out of those defenders. That was a
Totti,
pretty good goal there.
And that has just lasered into the corner.
Look at that.
Unstoppable.
Just run past him. No chance. Oh my days. Run with cruising it as the equator. Yeah, he's not even running to lose me. Oh my days. Like pace does not against the wing players.
Close. Here's Francesco Totti.
Trying to run, no.
Oscar.
Totti can't be in the pace.
Crowd taking serious action.
Well, it was badly timed. He didn't get the ball.
And oh no!
They've got that equalising
oh,
goal.
Oh, they've scored. They've actually
what
scored.
What a header it was. But it's flown over the top of the keeper.
Man. Defenders couldn't reach it. Goalkeeper was too slow to react.
Let's see the replay now.
Oh, my days. Wow. That was an on-point header, though. Not going to lie. Jeez. That's probably drawn us the game. Trying to send Grenier. Gets it. No.
Throw in now.
He ran away from the ball. He's too slow to reach onto it. Faster player like Aubameyang definitely would have reached that. That's a pain in the ass.
In like that.
All right, it's a definite foul, Martin. It's a slight tackle, but he just mistimed it badly.
Wonderful
oh,
save.
What a save.
Had to really reach out for that.
Fantastic
well,
save by Vardy Villa.
And it could break the game open again for them.
Cleo.
It's not easy, is it, when you're behind that wall?
Oh,
you can't
days.
Always see it, but fine handling by the keeper.
That was a fantastic save.
Period of extra time.
Albiol versus Matic. Nah, Matic's gone, even though it's Matic.
Diego Costa!
Oh, crap.
The shot's on!
Oh,
off the post!
He's at the post! Oh, my it's days, that was too nerve-wracking.
Got the ball well.
There we have it, guys. The game is over against Chelsea World Class. So, we did actually win on penalties. Just, like, 4-2. But that didn't beat the time of pace. throughout that game, I felt sometimes if I had the extra pace, I would have lost my man, gone through the goal and scored probably. So over the top three balls, you definitely need pace. Like weaving in and out of players, it doesn't really matter. Like most times, I find that pace isn't as important on FIFA 16. So I'd say having one or two quick players in your team is always important, because sometimes you're gonna need that pace. So in defense, I'd say like having Kurt Zouma when the game comes out, someone who's gonna have a lot more pace than John Terry, for example, it'll be okay, because John Terry, he's good at tackling and he can actually keep up pretty well, surprisingly, even though he's got 34 pace. So overall,
and he's going to pay the heavy price for it. He's going to be sent off. He is sent off.
Yeah, one of those challenges that strikers can only make. It was badly timed.
Overall, pace does not matter in FIFA 16. Well, I feel it doesn't. Look at this goal here. I just weave in and out of them too easily. See, that was a fantastic goal.
And he's put it away
so,
beautifully.
Yeah, I don't think pace matters. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. If you have enjoyed this video, give it a like. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the future.